I'm Vanessa Berlein. I'm a painter predominantly. I work in Cape Town. I grew up in Mpumalanga on a farm in a place called Kippersol. And I work out of Eastside Studios in Woodstock. It's a great studio, there are 10 of us in there, and all different mediums, mostly painting, but a great place to work out. I was looking for a vehicle to explore capturing people when they weren't aware of being captured on film, or finding that moment in between moments of poses. So, and I figured that if people have fancy dress on, if they choose to take on another persona in a party setting, they would start to become that person and take on a different personality. Please allow them to. Obviously, if there's good music and a bit of alcohol in the mix, people tend to relax more into it. And in that they lose a lot of their inhibitions, because it becomes such a dramatic, theatrical event. I think I love painting people. And I was always looking for a way in which to paint people where they weren't aware of the pose within the moment. I love painting flesh and trying to capture in motion within humanity and also iconic qualities in people. So that was more or less why I was looking for a vehicle, and that I chanced upon it. And I was looking at the surrealist balls that happened, the people in fancy dress, and the studio that I share with these 10 people and all the artists that I know, they just seemed like a wonderful group of people to get together to work with. So it almost became a collaboration as well, which was great. I love that in today's world we have such accessibility to different mediums, you know, through cell phones, through computers. 20 years ago you would have to get a cameraman with a camera. Today you just have you can use your cell phone, or you can use a small video camera, and you can upload it onto your own computer. So it becomes a very private way of working. Then I thought if I filmed the entire evening, which I did, I would be able to, in my own time, go back through the evening and look at what had been captured, and then grabbing photo stills off the videos of those moments when people weren't aware that they were being filmed. So that became really important to me, and capturing the atmosphere of the evening, the moments. And the colour as well. I mean, to be able to play with colour on film, with different apps that you can get, is amazing. And it's an amazing thing to explore all those tools that are out there. There's a quality in certain people that I find, there's certain people who sit very comfortably in this world, and they exhibit an amount of vulnerability, and they may be very unusual people or quirky, but they seem to have found a comfort level in this world, and they're not scared to go out there, and they have an enormous amount of empathy for others around them, because it's usually been quite a hard journey to get to the place where they've gotten to. And it's a wonderful thing to celebrate that. Yeah, obviously, I mean, even within the country, they differ. I mean, the audience in Johannesburg and Cape Town is very different, and in Mpumalanga, very different. Many of the exhibitions I've been on in Europe and the States, I haven't been there to witness the audience participation in the exhibition, but I imagine it is very different. So each community is very different. The way they react to things differs hugely. from South Africa, there are two artists who I'm loving at the moment. And the one artist, I went to see Deborah Bell's exhibition in Johannesburg at Revered Reed, and her figurative installation was phenomenal. I mean, it was tear-inducing. It was absolutely awe-inspiring. And I'm loving the work of Brad Gray, who is a painter, and the narrative that he captures within his work is astounding to me. And his technique is beautiful. Absolutely lovely. I would say spend a lot of time working on technique and understanding whatever medium you're working in, to try and gain as much understanding of it as possible. But you never lose the fun that comes with doing it. And to work as an artist, we're very blessed. Because life today is very hard. So don't see yourself as somebody who's suffering for their art. Rather see yourself as doing something that you're celebrating. And you are blessed, so be grateful. I've been asked to exhibit on two shows towards the end of the year, one in Valencia in Spain and one in New York in December, which I'm super excited about, obviously. But I try to produce one body of work a year to have a solo exhibition. So I'll carry on with the theme, with the way of working which I worked for this exhibition, because I love the process of it. So probably have another party, different theme, maybe a different group of people, and take it from there, see what comes out of it. Kind of open myself up to new possibilities.